This afternoon, we're learning new details about a deadly plane crash in Melbourne.
Three people were killed when the plane crashed into the woods on the edge of Melbourne International Airport back in February. WESH 2's Dan Bellow is live in Melbourne. And Dan, you spent the day going through the report that explains what happened.
That's right, Jim. And I have also talked with the owner of the plane who was not on board. And he says it was a perfect storm of things going wrong that downed the plane. And he also said that a flight controller, an air traffic controller working in that tower, needed retraining after the crash. An air traffic controller giving routine instructions to pilots sent two planes toward the same Melbourne Airport runway last February, according to a new report from the National Transportation Safety Board. Local theater owner Robert Curris was the pilot. James Franklin and Justin Gaines were passengers. All three were killed. The plane had just refueled at nearby Valkyria, so it was heavy. It turned toward the runway in an unfavorable wind. That was strike two. Strike three, another plane was about to land on the same runway. Curris, the pilot, was already turning to land ahead of that other plane. "No, sir," the tower radioed. "I needed you to follow the other plane. Cut it in tight right now. Cut it in tight." According to the plane's owner, who spoke off camera, that tight turn was the last straw and slowed the plane to the point that it dropped out of the air.
There were witnesses in airplanes in the air that saw the airplane depart controlled flight, descend vertically to ground contact.
Now, this report from the National Transportation Safety Board is not the final report that assigns cause or blame. The official cause of the accident is not yet available and won't be for another several weeks when the last and final report comes out. We're live in Melbourne. Dan Bellow, WESH 2 News.